happening? Happy Tuesday. It is Allison from Wonderlass.com, and today I am randomly hopping in for a quick little fun tutorial on how to create your own custom desktop folders. So I am totally obsessed with branding and making sure that everything is in my pretty brand colors. Plus, I just like things to look nice. And I'm also an organization freak. So everything on my desktop needs to be organized in all my folders, nice and neat, needs to look good, and it needs to be easy to find. And so in my Facebook group that I have, I frequently post different photos of my customizations that I make, including my desktop folders. And so I had people asking me over and over and over again how the Sam Hill I create these custom desktop folders. So that is what I'm going to share with you today. And it is super, super easy. Unfortunately, I think, unless I'm wrong, I think it's only available for Mac users because I'm going to be showing you how to use a really quick and easy app. Okay, so if you want to customize your desktop folders, so for example, this is a snapshot of my custom desktop folder. So if you use a Mac, you know that the default for your desktop folders is blue. And blue is fine and everything, but it's boring, especially when all of your folders are in blue and when they don't match your brand colors and you're mental about branding, well, then that blue color just isn't good enough. So you can customize your folders, make them all different colors, pretty much any color that you want. And you can also add photos and, in my case, doodles. So that is what I'm going to be showing you how to do right now. So I'm going to screen share with you right at the moment. And so here you are seeing my lovely desktop screen. This over here is OBS, which is what I'm using to broadcast to you right now. It's a little bit of Inception going on. Oh my gosh, Inception! Okay, it's so weird. It just keeps going on. Okay, anyway, so that's OBS, so don't pay attention to that. This is my desktop. Hello, BMO. That is, I'm obsessed with Adventure Time. My boyfriend made me that cute little desktop background. But back to the point. So here is the application you're going to use to create your desktop folders. It's called Image to Icon. So you can literally just Google this. It's image spelled normally as image, the number 2, and then icon. Image to Icon. You can Google that or just look it up in the iTunes store or the little Apple App Store, whatever it's called, and it'll come up for you. So once you pull it up, this is what it looks like, and it is mind-blowingly easy to create things with. So here I have, right here, I've got 2 PNG files. So these are different from JPEGs. PNGs allow you to save the photograph or image with a transparent background. So if this photo right here, for example, this little rainbow that I'm moving up and down, if that were a JPEG, then I would be stuck with that white background. And so if I wanted to put it on, say, a pink background, then I would be stuck with that white background and border, which I don't want. So by creating and saving files as PNGs, I can save with a clear background. So I recommend using PNG files so that you can have the same, not have to worry about the backgrounds. So once you get whatever image, and you can use photographs, in this case, I have turned my doodles into PNGs, but you literally just drag it from your desktop or whatever it is onto the application, and then you'll see this lovely little scroll bar pop up, and this is where you can scroll and see all of your different options, and this is where your mind is gonna be blown, because when you scroll down, you're gonna start seeing not only can you customize your folders, but you can customize your hard drive. So if you use a Mac, you know that you're forced to have this ugly gray hard drive on your desktop, but you can customize it to look really pretty. So you'll see mine right here. It's like this adorable, I've customized it to be my favorite color of teal with a storm cloud on it. So you can customize that. You can customize USB drive icons, SD disks, documents, DVD cases, CD stuff. Not that many of us use CDs anymore, but there are so many, like pretty much any different icon that you have on your Mac, you can customize to look how you want. So let's stick with the folders because that's what this tutorial is all about. So I usually go with the full folder, so which that's the very top option. You just click on it. once you click on it, you'll see a little button. It's kind of hard to see in this tutorial because it's so small, but it looks like three little dots and three little lines. That's your options menu. So you just click there, and it's really self-explanatory. So this is where you can adjust your image and have it placed exactly how you want. So horizontal offset, you just move the arrow back and forth. You can see it moves it from side to side. Vertical offset moves it up and down. And then, of course, zoom, you can make it bigger or smaller so you can get it just the way you want it. And then rotation, of course, that means you can rotate your image. And lastly, once you get your image in place, you just click the little background color and this will pop up. And you can use the color wheel and just play around with the color options there, or you can go to the little sliders and then actually enter in, if you have an exact brand color, for example, that you want to use, just enter in the hex code. And it'll pop up and you can customize it the way you want. When you're done, you just click outside of that little options window, it'll go away. And when you're ready to export, you just hit the export button right here. You choose what you want to save it as. In this case, you want to save it as a folder. So you check folder, give it a name. So we'll just call it Rainbow. You can choose where you want to save it. I want to save it on my desktop, and then save folder. Bam, and let me show you where it went. I can't find it. Oh, here it is. Yay, there it is, all saved, all done. And when you are ready to keep creating, because once you do one, it's like that Pringle saying, once you pop, you can't stop. If you create one folder, you're gonna wanna do like all your folders. So you just hit the little back button and start again and drag in a new image and customize whatever the heck other icons that you want to do. But it is literally so much fun. When I figured out how to do this, my mind was blown, and I spent like the entire day, everything that I had scheduled and planned to work on that day went out the window because I was like, I just need to customize all my folders. So much fun. So that's your tutorial for today. And speaking of customizations, if you want to learn shiz tons more customizations, for example, I have lots of people always asking me how I turn my doodles into graphics, all of that stuff. I actually have a course called Be Your Own Brand that goes into all things branding, personalizing your brand to make it awesome and totally unique, total you, and that is pre-enrolling until tomorrow night at less than half the price. So the doors close tomorrow night at midnight. And it will not be available again until the end of August. And when it's available at the end of August, it's going to be coming out at more than twice what it costs right now. So if you're at all interested in that, be sure to check it out. It's at the link above. But we're going to be going into all different things to do for your brand. Doodles, graphics, how to take your own professional photos, stock photos, bio photos, step-by-step creating an amazing brand that looks and feels great. All right? But that's only available until tomorrow night. So that is it for today. Create some folders. Go download that app. Feel free to share them below in the comments. I would love to geek out and see your creations. All right. Well, with that in mind, I'm going to go try to not be sidetracked with creating more folders and actually do some work. So I will see you guys later. Bye.